You've been observing a little bit of tremor. I'm just going to relax your hands here. Okay. This is, thank you for reading the textbook, a fairly classic rest tremor. Sometimes patients don't follow the textbooks, though, and they don't have this rest tremor. So I'm kind of putting this in a bit of a relaxed position here, because sometimes this will bring out the tremor more. If patients will hold their hand or, again, sit on their hands, you might miss it. But it tends to be this rotational. So rather than a flexion extension tremor, it tends to be a rotational tremor, tends to be a little bit more in the fingers sometimes too. That's where you get that pill rolling where the fingers are moving with the wrist. It looks like someone's rolling a pill. That's where that comes from. And sometimes it'll transmit to other parts of the body, but sometimes actually looking at pant legs is a really good way to look to see if there's leg tremor or not, because you won't actually see the leg move, but you might see the pant leg move a little bit. So this is a classic rest tremor when someone has no tone. Then there's also postural tremor. So bring the hands up like this and hold them. Notice how initially that tremor completely went away in the right hand. We're just going to keep your hands up there for a second and keep them up, keep them up. Sometimes you will get a reemergence of the rest tremor in a postural position. I see just a tiny little bit in that pinky and a little bit in the thumb, but not that much. And go ahead and relax again. And so rest, posture, and then the third thing we do is the kinetic tremor. So with that hand, touch your finger to my finger and touch your nose. Touch my finger nice and slow. Nose, finger. Nose, finger, excellent. And we'll do this side with that finger. Finger, nose, nose. So you notice just a little bit of shaking there in that movement. So there was a little bit of a kinetic tremor. That's pretty common. Most patients with rest tremor also have postural and kinetic tremor. For you, your rest tremor was the most pronounced of that. And that's classic for Parkinson's disease. Contrast that with essential tremor, which is not Parkinson's, but just a tremor syndrome. Those individuals tend to have a more dominant postural and kinetic and less of a rest tremor. But they don't not have a rest tremor. About a third of people with essential tremor will have a rest tremor, and some people with Parkinson's will have a very pronounced postural and kinetic tremor. So you can't really distinguish Parkinson's tremor from essential tremor just based on the tremor characteristics. It'll be on your board tests. They'll say, oh, someone has postural kinetic tremor, that means essential tremor. Someone has rest tremor, that means Parkinson's. But that's not the reality of how patients present. And so you really can't use the tremor characteristics. You have to look for the bradykinesia. People with essential tremor will not have the bradykinesia. That's the key part. Sometimes tone can be a little bit difficult because the tremor will actually interfere with the tone exam, and so you feel the notching, but it's not actually increased, so the tone can be hard. It's really the bradykinesia that differentiates essential tremor from Parkinson's. But those are the three parts of the tremor exam that we do, is rest, posture, and then kinetic. Notice that I had him go slow, and I kept my finger in one place. If I was doing an ataxia exam, I would have done it a little bit differently. So now I'm going to have you do the finger, nose, finger, but I'm going to have you go a little faster, and I'm going to move my finger around in space, okay?
Here we go.
All right. Perfect. Excellent. I'll do it on this side, too.
Okay.
All right. Okay, so that's more of an ataxia exam. That's the cerebellum that I was challenging there. He's having to change direction dynamically while moving in space with a little bit more speed. Yeah. He can hit my target every single time. There's a little bit of a tremor there, but there's nothing wrong with the cerebellum. It's working just fine. He's making these fine micro movements to get finger on finger exactly where it needs to be. There's just a little bit of tremor. Someone who has ataxia will be searching for it and will be smacking my hand sideways. And the faster I go and the more I move in space, the harder it becomes for them to get it. So that tells you there's something going on with the cerebellum, which generally we don't see in Parkinson's disease. That would make me think of something like multiple system atrophy if someone had a lot of ataxia.